Greg Gumbel in New York. Two more games ready to tip as we speak. Number 12, Western Kentucky against number 5, Drake in the West region. Number 10, St. Mary's against the Miami Hurricanes, the number 7 seed in the South. We'll send you off to Tim Brando and Mike Jaminski in Tampa, Ian Eagle and Jim Spanarkle in Little Rock.
CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four brings you to Tampa, Florida. A 12-5 matchup between Western Kentucky and Drake. As you look at the brackets, the winner of today's game will advance to take on the winner of Connecticut and San Diego coming up a bit later. Young Darren Horn, only 31 years of age, in his fifth season as head coach, was a 4-year letter winner for Western Kentucky, graduating in 95. The starting lineups for his team include the outstanding player of the year in the Sun Belt, Courtney Lee, Brazelton, Rogers, Magley, and Evans, the rest of his starting five. And for Drake, the darlings of this tournament, Young, Emenecker, Houston, Corver, and Cox. For Keno Davis, the Missouri Valley Conference Coach of the Year, the son of Dr. Tom, who's taken on the Midwest by storm. And it's great to have you with us for this matchup today. Today's game brought to you in HDTV by HP. Our officials for this afternoon's first game in Tampa, Jamie Lucky, Paul Fea, and Michael Stevens. Tim Brando alongside Mike Jaminski, happy to have you with us. This should be a very enjoyable game.
Well, you know, Western Kentucky likes to get out. They like to pressure you, score points off turnovers, Tim. Drake a little bit more controlling of the tempo, but play a wide open style in the half court.
Courtney Lee takes it right to the rack, and Evans there to follow it home.
Well, and if there's an advantage for Western Kentucky, it's inside, and Jeremy Evans has been playing at a high level the last couple of games.
Both teams rely so heavily on the outside shot, but they spread the floor. Western Kentucky, admittedly, will score more in transition than will Drake, but they both rely heavily on their outside shooting touch.
Well, Drake really likes to spread the floor on the offense, have a couple guys who can dribble, drive, and get in penetration, but good block that time. Again, the interior on offense and defense probably slighted to Western Kentucky.
This is Lee, a young man that out of Indianapolis has really come on strong, and there's that runner that he can always hit. He's got the ability to hit the outside shot, can create his own. Absolutely a star to watch in this NCAA tournament.
20 points a game for him, Tim, and he is the one guy who can kind of get his own offense, and when things are bogged down for the Hilltoppers, they really look to him to manufacture points.
First tournament appearance for Drake since 1971. Those great teams under Mari John were Final Four participants in the late 60s. And from downtown, that one does not fall.
Great matchup between Brazelton and Emenecker at the point.
Houston and Young are both outstanding shooters for Drake. Leonard tried and missed that last three a moment ago, and Emenecker, the player of the year in the Valley, a walk-on team that's got so many incredible stories that they turn it over this time, still looking for their first hoop.
Well, Corver that time, I think he surprised his teammates looking inside for the pass, and normally when he's outside and has an open look, the ball is going up to the rim.
Tyrone Brazelton, senior out of Chicago by way of Missouri State, operating at the point for Western Kentucky.
Drake will play a little man, but in a matchup zone a lot of the time.
There's an alley-oop attempt, but it's well defended by Leonard Houston. Saves it into the hands of Adam Emenecker. And he decided to drive it all the way through and is fouled. Take a look at the tournament resume for Keno Davis's club. They were picked dead last in the preseason, wound up 15-3 in the conference, 28-4, absolutely blew away Illinois State in the Missouri Valley Conference Championship.
Timmy, this is a 5-12 matchup, but I think these teams are a lot closer than that would indicate.
Yeah, agreed. And frankly, an interesting point can be made that Drake comes from a league, Mike, that has had recent success in the NCAA tournament, that being the Missouri Valley, while the Sun Belt has struggled some. Nice runner, beautifully done by Jonathan Cox. But this team out of the Sun Belt, though they have not had recent success in that conference, they are very athletic. Emenecker reaching in picks up that foul.
Well, you saw Jonathan Cox the last go around, and he is also a guy, he's the second walk-on starter on the floor for Drake, but has the ability to stretch the floor with his shot and can also put it on the dribble.
Houston sits down, and Brent Hinskirk, the first opportunity to go to the bench for Keno Davis, and he'll go deep into that bench for Drake. Both of these clubs like to play a lot of guys with the style of play they employ.
I think it's really key for both of these teams to hit an early start to try to get out. Both of them have a lot of energy going here early.
Lee, not this time on the wing. Well defended by Emin Ecker.
You know, it's the amazing dynamic. Both these teams played over 32 games this year. You battle, you win your conference championship, you get to the NCAA tournament, and it could be over in 40 minutes.
That's right. Western Kentucky had to win it on South Alabama's home floor. They were knocked out of the tournament by Middle Tennessee, was Ronnie Arrow's club. Of course, still made it in as an at-large entry. So two teams out of the Sun Belt in this year's tournament.
Great passing to Magley. Beautifully done by Courtney Lee. That was an outstanding touch pass he made underneath the basket.
Well, Magley was kind of the wild card. The coaching staff didn't know if he was going to be able to defend out on the perimeter, but if he can score inside, it may make Drake force to match up to him.
Hinskirk trying that pick and pop. There's a beautiful move. What a scoop by Emin Ecker. Unable to get it to go. Basket does not count. There was some interference there, but I believe would have been called had the ball gone through the hoop.
Well, and that's the point that I was making. There was a switch off that time, and Magley was out on Emin Ecker, and good recognition on Emin Ecker's part. When you saw you have a big on you, you want to try to exploit him off the dribble, and there was no way he could move laterally fast enough to stay with Emin Ecker.
Just an incredible story, this young man. Academic All-America. Original walk-on. Was only really offered a baseball scholarship coming out of high school. Boston College loved him as a shortstop, a guy that could really hit the ball well, hit 380. But wanted to play basketball in the worst way. And from an academic standpoint, four majors, made one lousy B in business management.
And it's an incredible story. And it just doesn't happen where a guy's a walk-on for 3 years and then becomes the MVP of his conference.
Yeah, it's amazing. Until this year, he never averaged more than 8 minutes of playing time per game. Emin Ecker. Mendez Valdez, not this time. There's Magley on the offensive glass, rolling it through. You can see that athletic approach that Western Kentucky has, Mike, makes a difference on the offensive boards.
Well, and he's the wide body that Drake really doesn't have a matchup for.
Korver, and if that shot looks familiar, it should. Brother Kyle was outstanding at Creighton, and that defensive play by Korver leads to a travel by Lee. Timeout, out of the gates quickly in Tampa. A 5-12 matchup, and it's 8-7 Hilltoppers.
Western Kentucky leading it by one. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski here at the West Region in Tampa, Florida. As you look at young Darren Horn, looks like he could still play today, doesn't he? Bowling Green, Kentucky, a rich tradition of basketball there. Diddle Arena, one of the outstanding places to play in Bowling Green. And he's a part of the last victory that the Sun Belt Conference ever had in the NCAA.
Well, 420 win seasons for him in a row, played under Ralph Willard, and he's a terrific player there. And it's got to be hard for him to go back to your alma mater. I mean, there are seven coaches in the tournament who are doing that this year, but certainly a lot of pressure.
Leonard Houston goes to the other wing and gives Drake its first lead, 10-8.
What we're seeing here early are teams playing to their strengths. Western Kentucky going inside with Evans and Magley, and then, of course, the three-point shooting for Drake.
Courtney Lee dumps it down, gets it into Magley's hands. There's Rogers. That ball was tipped. It was deflected. Houston goes the other way. Rogers has it taken away by Houston.
By Leonard Houston just playing. He's got long arms, was able to get up and block a jump shot and then create points on the other end.
Drake now very quick, showing their athletic side with the deflections and rejections leading to easy baskets.
One of the most improved defensive teams in the country. Keno Davis really working on that part of the game.
Mendez Valdez trying to feed his man Jeremy Evans inside, turns it over.
There's the look. I mean, that is so hard to block a jump shot. And then he just creates it, just strong to the basketball, ripping it away and scoring.
And welcome to the game, Ty Rogers. The ball's going the other way. And you hear this partisan group from Des Moines, Iowa, that made their way into Central Florida. Let's go, Drake, as Emin Ecker leads his team. That's a textbook play, isn't it?
Absolutely textbook, the way he creates that opening for the three ball. Jonathan Cox.
He reminds me so much of Steve Nash, and that's a lot to put on a guy, but he controls the offense for Drake.
Magley in traffic uses the glass. That ended an 11-0 run for the Bulldogs.
After a quality start by Western Kentucky, got them the early lead. Both teams shooting better than 50% out of the gates. And then Ecker has his pocket pick this time, and we've got a tie ball with the arrow to the Bulldogs.
There's the look. He goes around Magley again. And just great court vision. You just, you know, it's so tough to do that. Penetrate and kick back for the open three. Jonathan Cox, one of those guys we talked about, can spread the offense and also put it on the floor.
Houston decides to challenge Magley inside. And will force the foul from the big fella. His first. Second, I beg your pardon. Which is significant. Horn will have to look to his bench now because Magley has an early second foul. Not quite 6.5 minutes gone.
Well, and we talked about the pressures on him to defend out on the perimeter, and we thought going on that Stephon Pettigrew might play a big role off the bench as somebody up front to play along Evans, who can maybe defend out on the perimeter.
Courtney Lee will come into the game for the time being. This makes Western Kentucky a smaller team, which is, given the matchup against Drake, something that Darren Horn can deal with.
And Magley was the most effective offensive player they had so far, 3 of 3 in the game. So yep. He was, you know, he was getting it done on one end, but giving things up on the other end.
They had 6 of their 10 points. And just like that, a quick foul against Lee. Darren Horn's like, you got to be kidding me. I just got him into the game, and there's another foul. Already 14 fouls against the Hilltoppers, only one for Drake. Houston, he's relentless. This time it's an offensive foul. Player control against Houston.
Here's a nice step in. Good anticipation, not giving up the baseline.
Morris Siakam, the senior from Cameroon, into the game, helping to induce the charging call.
Just a little token pressure. Brazelton, very difficult to put full court pressure on, so fast with the basketball.
With Magley out of there, let's see how that changes this offense. They were capable of making that interior pass to set up open shots when Magley was on the floor.
Well, you know, and Evans had talked about it, 20 points, 14 rebounds against Middle Tennessee in the championship game, really come alive offensively. But against this matchup zone, they're going to have to get some penetration off the dribble.
John Michael Hall now trying to check Brazelton. He gives it up. Slaughter just into the game, gives it up to Valdez. Brazelton from downtown. Oh, that's a nice three for Tyrone, the senior from Chicago.
Really dominates the basketball for the Hilltoppers. A 41% three-point shooter, so you have to honor that.
Korver on the wing. It's amazing how much he looks like his brother, isn't it?
You know what? If you watch film of him and he didn't have a number on, you know exactly who it is.
Brazelton with an answer. Three ball after three ball.
I don't think the shot clock's going to go off much in this game, Tim. Both of these teams. Like I said, Western Kentucky a little bit more than Drake, but they both like to play at tempo.
Emskirk setting the pick. Korver trying to get away. Emin Ecker challenged by Lee, who comes over with a rejection. Well, we spoke of Kyle Korver. I recall in 2002 he helped lead Creighton against Florida in an opening round game that came down to a buzzer beater for the Blue Jays in a victory against Billy Donovan's team in Chicago. As we come back, a nice Leonard Houston alley-oop. And it's 20-16, break by four.
We talk about guys who play bigger than they are, and Houston listed at 6'3", but probably plays at about 6'6", because of his jumping ability and the length of his arms.
That three won't fall for Rogers. Taken down by Houston.
Rogers is a guy, most of his shots are going to come from behind the arc. You got to try to guard him.
Korver again, this time not there. And a push.
That was almost from the NCAA logo.
Yeah. Foul goes against Ty Rogers. Timeout. Both teams shooting 58%, a scintillating start.
Free game.
All right, guys, let's get you back to Tampa. Western Kentucky and Drake. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski.
Just over 9 minutes gone in Tampa. And the three ball barrage continues between Western Kentucky and Drake. Courtney Lee with a little stop and go runner. He hit one of those earlier, but not this time. Leonard Houston the rebound.
Almost half of the field goals attempted in this game so far are threes, Tim.
Korver decides to drive. That's an offensive foul. Orlando Mendez Valdez, the junior from San Antonio, got in position to pick it up. NCAA March Madness On Demand is streaming every game from the NCAA Championship online for free. You can watch any game anytime at the new NCAA.com.
Tim, you know, Mendez Valdez, certainly not the speed of Brazelton, but very important off the bench for Western Kentucky. 41% from behind the arc, very steady with the ball. Not a great athlete, but you saw right there, does the little things that help you.
Brazelton now with Courtney Lee. Mendez Valdez, Pettigrew is back into the game, and there's the dish to Evans. Those are the five on the floor. Jeremy Evans, another one of those athletic, longer sophomore players that could give Drake some matchup difficulty today.
One, he finishes well around the rim and inside. Two, he's quick enough to stay out on the perimeter against the outside bigs for Drake.
12-5 run now for the Hilltoppers.
You think that you look at Evans, he is matched up now against Jonathan Cox. So a positive matchup there for Western Kentucky.
Shot clock winding down. They get it into the hands of Young, who pumps. That ball only caught the backboard. Now they're saying that the clock, I believe 1 second should be on the shot clock. And I believe that's what Paul Fea is instructing Jamie Lucky, the lead official, to. The clock continued to run, and we heard the horn, but clearly 1 second should be remaining time for a catch and shoot for Drake.
Well, they had a success off the lob inside. Leonard Houston being checked by Mendez Valdez. Here's a look on the you can see the shot clock upper heart, and is
no doubt ought to be 1 second.
Yep.
And the ball caught, did not catch the iron. It caught the back of the glass.
If not two.
Yeah.
If not 2 seconds.
Well, this stoppage of play is only to get the 1 second back up on the clock, on the 35-second clock.
And a little benefit here, you can see now they've got Courtney Lee guarding Leonard Houston. That's a much better mismatch. Now they take away the lob opportunity.
Emma Necker comes back in. And apparently we're still having some kind of problem with the clock. Paul Fea says, we have maybe a second remaining, but we don't have it operating just yet. Coming up at halftime, Greg Clark and Seth with live look-ins, tournament news, and more coming up on At the Half. There's Houston. They go for the alley-oop, and they get the quick foul.
They got the screen anyway. This is the second time they've done that play, and you know, I've always looked at it, Timmy, that out of bounds plays are a lot like special teams in football, and you have to have a positive possession there. And Leonard Houston has done a terrific job getting up to the rim with only 1 second left.
Pettigrew got the foul, his first. And that'll put Leonard Houston at the line. You could almost see that one coming, couldn't you?
Well, and then they had the direct one when they had Mendez Valdez on him, but then they ran the screen and still had the same effect.
Eight points and four boards already for Leonard Houston.
This was another guy. I mean, you know, yes, Keno Davis. I mean, did you see it coming from Emenek, or did you see it coming from Cox or Houston? All three of them played well above levels that the coaching staff were even expecting.
One of those incredible stories, capturing lightning in a bottle, but also credit Keno Davis with an innovative offensive style that he decided to use because of the talent he had. Evans with a putback, and that's been one of Western Kentucky's strengths. Length of the floor. What a pass into the hands of Young.
All right, Josh Young sprinting out, and that's the thing that's disheartening as a coach. You get a second chance opportunity inside, you score, and they run it right up your back in about 2 seconds.
That sequence, Mike, emblematic of the style of play we're going to see. I think maybe 4.5 seconds went off the clock between baskets. Courtney Lee with another one of those beautiful floaters off the dribble in the lane.
They need him to start to take over, be a little bit more assertive. Only his fourth field goal or sixth field goal attempt, only 2 of 6 so far in this game.
He really looks like the game comes easily to him, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's got his great handle. Does so many things well with the ball. Just under 40% from three, just under 50% inside of that. So a very high percentage shooter.
Emenecker taking advantage of having the taller Evans on him. Used his speed to get to the lane and is fouled.
Well, here's the thing. You let a guy get to his right hand like that, and he's got the ability to elevate. We talked about playing against Drake's defense. You've got to get penetration. Courtney Lee very good at finding his own offense.
Evans got the foul, his first, and we should mention that DJ Magley, the outstanding freshman post player for Western Kentucky, has been out since the 13 and a half minute mark, having picked up 2 quick fouls, and he had 6 of Western Kentucky's first 10 points.
And I think Emenecker drew both of those fouls on him as well, so they're getting caught in switches, and he's making them pay.
Saginaw, Michigan zone, Adam Emenecker. A.J. Slaughter re-enters the game for Tyrone Brazelton. And Emenecker will also get a brief blow. Josh Parker in for him. There's another pick. One of those quick hands of Leonard Houston. We've seen it a couple of times today.
And there's a logo on the floor. Mendez Valdez looked over at it. And they're cleaning it up right now, and that seems to be a slick part of the floor. And you've seen that when those things are applied to the floor, they can be a little bit dicey to handle. Yep. On
Houston at the free throw line, where he's 78% on the year. Well, after backing up Nick Grant the past few years, he stepped into the forefront for this Drake team. They lost a lot of seniors on this club, and Dr. Tom Davis, we know so well, having been around Gary Williams and Bruce Pearl, the style of offense he usually employs. This is nothing like what Dr. Tom used to run.
Well, and that's the thing. I mean, he runs the flex, and really was the innovator of the flex offense. But as Keno was telling us yesterday, he said, I've got to coach the guys that I have right now, and they are not suited to that system. Evans inside, he has been very effective down low. But that's great coaching. To take a look at what you have and then devise an offense that suits them.
7:44 remaining. Drake by 2 in this 5-versus-12 matchup. As you look at our game summary, it's quick to note that we've had an 11-0 Drake run, Mike Jaminski. We've had a 12-5 answer from Western Kentucky. Both teams showing the ability to score in bunches.
Well, and they're doing it different ways. Western Kentucky, Evans and Magley, 7 of 7, 14 points inside. Yeah. Drake getting a lot of their stuff on the perimeter from 3, 4 of 10.
Adam Emenecker is living up to the advanced billing, and I'd say Courtney Lee has as well. You see Magley coming back onto the floor after those 2 early fouls, and he and Jeremy Evans inside have been a difference. Evans will trigger the ball in for the Hilltoppers.
Well, and another thing where they're dominating at the free throw line as well. This is something that Drake does. They play very sound defense. They don't foul, and they don't put their opponents at the line.
And get a steal out of the inbounds. Emenecker operating along with Josh Young in the backcourt. Houston feeding Korver. And inside, they've got Hemskirk in the game, number four.
A little bit of a matchup zone, and that's, I think, in an effort to try to save Magley and not have him to not let him guard one-on-one out on the perimeter.
And then Ecker splits that zone and then lost it. Beautiful defense that time by Evans in Western Kentucky zone. Lee from way downtown. Count it.
Now Courtney Lee showing superior distance on that, just under 40% from three.
Korver tries to answer, but to no avail. Slaughter the long rebound for Western Kentucky. And there's a bump. Foul will go against Josh Young trying to check Brazelton. Look at the distance on this.
That's at least 6 feet beyond the college three. Courtney Lee rising up. We talked about it. And because of that, you're going to have to honor that shot. And that allows him to get driving lanes inside.
Jacob Barenbrook. Barenbrook into the game, the junior from Wisconsin. And that's a 5 second violation. So inbound difficulties for Evans. He threw one away a moment ago underneath his own basket and now commits the 5 second violation.
But that's, you have to put that on the team right there. And Western Kentucky fell asleep with the ball out of bounds, and Evans really didn't have any other outlets to throw to. You have to go and bail that guy out and make yourself available.
Barenbrook, number 11, Spring Green, Wisconsin, River Valley High School, into the game for the first time for the Bulldogs, joining Emenecker in the backcourt. Korver tries the skip pass. It was deflected, but it goes right into the hands of Houston. And a foul on the baseline extended as Jonathan Cox got tied up. And the foul does go against Jeremy Evans. That's his second. So the two Hilltopper big men inside each have a pair of fouls.
The way to beat the zone is to throw across it. Nice skip pass. And then Jonathan Cox showing you the ability not only to get outside but reposition himself on the weak side of the glass and get an offensive rebound.
Well, feel the heat when Monday's number one drama returns with an all-new episode. CSI Miami at 10, 9 Central on CBS. All new episodes coming.
And this is such a, Drake's such a tough team to defend, Tim, especially with the zone, because they've got guys like Cox and Korver who can get in the middle of it and make plays out. You have to respect their ability to shoot. And they're all very good ball handlers. So whether you're playing man or zone, this is a very dangerous team.
Young man that was also a walk-on originally, earned his scholarship after his freshman year, Cox. Well, Drake made their last 8 free throws. They're 10 out of 12 overall. That's been a real key stat for them in this game offensively. 6 minutes left here in the opening half.
Those two may be the two of the best walk-ons in the history of the Missouri Valley Conference.
Cannot doubt their productivity, no doubt about that. Slaughter from downtown. He hits a three. A.J., sophomore from Shelbyville, Kentucky.
Well, Slaughter giving him nice production off the bench. Perfect from the floor.
Young. Korver tries to keep it alive, and there's Jonathan Cox with the putback.
Well, with Magley out of the game, and Drake is really getting to the offensive glass.
Rogers feeds Lee, uses the glass. Boy, that runner, and he knows how to use the window as well. He's hit 3 of those in this first half.
Well, when you crowd him, he's got the ability. I like the one dribble and then the 2-foot stop. It takes away any charge.
That's a walk by John Michael Hall. And Leonard Houston will get back onto the floor, and Hall sits down. Youngster from Moultrie, Georgia, leading the game as Houston gets in. Brent Hemskirk also coming back onto the floor. Jonathan Cox sits down.
Both of these teams, Tim, falling into their type of rhythm. This game heading to an 85-point game for both of them.
Yeah. Should be a fun finish.
Very entertaining.
Slaughter has numbers, 2-on-1. Oh, and he's rejected. Hemskirk did the job.
Held his ground. Young for three. The iron unkind. Pulled down by Courtney Lee.
Well, in the open court, he's something. Although that time he got a little too energetic and picked up the player control foul.
Here's the look. I thought Slaughter, he really didn't have a lot of separation here. There was a man back. Evans was there inside. But a nice defensive play by Hemskirk. Just held his ground. Went right up in the air and had a good block. Absorbed the punishment. Sent the ball the other way.
Lee picking up his second foul, Mike. We'll have to keep an eye on that now in the second half. Magley with two. Evans with two. Courtney Lee now with two.
I talked about the two-foot jump stop before. That time he went off of 1 foot in the lane, and Korver really did a nice job stepping inside.
So foul difficulty could become problematic for the Hilltoppers.
And going out all the way out, it's going to be a double bonus shooting for Drake too. So yep. That we talked about it, a huge, they are a plus 10. The Hilltoppers have not attempted a free throw in this game.
And Slaughter gets a little overly aggressive and picks up the foul going for the steal. 3:56 remaining. Darren Horn trying to get the Sun Belt a win in the NCAAs. Getting a scholarship with zero skills, about as unbelievable as getting real Coke taste and zero calories. Win a $25,000 scholarship from Coke Zero at mycokerewards.com. Well, a few interested observers here behind us along press row. Mike Jaminski, one Jim Calhoun, his assistant, George Blaney. Those two men care deeply about the outcome of this game, provided they win against San Diego in our next matchup here from Tampa, Florida.
And took a one-year hiatus from the tournament last year after losing to George Mason the year before. Jim Calhoun and his Huskies very happy to be back in the NCAA tournament.
Josh Young gets the free throws to fall. A game of runs, an 11-0 run for Drake, a 12-5 answer by Kentucky. A little foul difficulty for the Hilltoppers. Three of their star players each have two, including Sun Belt Player of the Year Courtney Lee, is currently sitting with two fouls. There's a trap, almost led to a turnover. Brazelton leaves it to Mendez Valdez. Feeds Ty Rogers, who gets it to fall.
Pretty good find by Mendez Valdez. He was buried in a trap, but able to pick up Rogers on the weak side.
Brent Heemskirk is coming to the low post. Number four back into the game now for Drake. The rebound cleared, gets it back to Brazelton for three. Wow. He and Slaughter read one another beautifully.
That's just with Slaughter in the game. It allows Brazelton to move off the ball and become a scorer. 13.5 points a game for him on the year.
A 10-4 run now for Western Kentucky. And they lead by five. Just been back and forth between these two champions of the Missouri Valley and Sun Belt conferences. Western Kentucky won the tournament title. There's a nice look inside, but Houston unable to finish. Brazelton now. Slaughter feeds Rogers. The extra pass to Mendez Valdez. That ball was deflected. Beautifully done by Jonathan Cox. Well, a lot of deflections and rejections by Drake. Houston feeding. That's a player control foul.
Tim, it's interesting. Western Kentucky has gone really small. Four guards out there around Siakam. They've been pretty effective.
He's drawn two of them, has Boris Siakam. And Houston now with a couple of fouls. Both of them charges. And Boris, the senior from Cameroon, has gotten himself in position beautifully on both occasions. Rogers will trigger in the inbounds. How Western Kentucky holds up without some of their interior players, as well as Courtney Lee, the last few moments of this half. Very important.
as Brazelton takes it inside and he's fouled.
But then, you know, you look at it, Tim, and Western Kentucky on the year 39% from three, so a higher percentage than Drake. They don't take as many, but out on the floor they've got very capable shooters in Brazelton, Slaughter, Mendez, Valdez, and Rogers.
Young got the foul, his second. Western Kentucky without some of its star talent the last 5 minutes with some foul difficulty, not only maintaining itself but advancing its lead. There's a near turnover. Siakam almost lost it. Brazelton now works off the bounce, off the front iron.
You've got your entire starting front line for Western Kentucky out of the game right now.
A three ball by Baron Brook, that junior from Wisconsin. Drake had missed its last nine trays and he ended the drought. And Mendez Valdez says, "I'll see you and raise you from downtown."
Both teams playing behind the three-point arc right now. Not a lot of post touches.
I know you take that personally.
It is what it is.
It is. Amenecker with a stop and go. Leaves it for Cox in traffic, and he draws the foul.
He got sandwiched that time on the baseline.
You know, and at the start of the game, we would have never said that Jonathan Cox had an advantage inside, but he has done a lot in the paint area, just kind of shaping up to penetration and making himself available. But this small team out on the floor for Western Kentucky, he's got the advantage down low.
A.J. Slaughter picked up the foul, becomes the fourth Hilltopper to collect his second. Cox, the leading rebounder for this team.
It's amazing. Western Kentucky with a 5-point lead, Tim, and they have not attempted a free throw in this game.
Amazing.
But shooting a very high percentage from the floor, 18 of 29 so far.
He gets one of the two, and the lead is four for Western Kentucky. And again, doing this without Courtney Lee, without Jeremy Evans. Mendez Valdez from way downtown. Brazelton gets the long rebound. We've seen, as you mentioned earlier, a lot of long rebounds and runouts off of those long rebounds.
That shot was from St. Pete Beach.
Slaughter ripping up the nets. A.J. Slaughter.
They're playing Drake basketball right now and beating them at it.
Korver. Brazelton gets the long rebound and doing it without their stars. There's the feed to Siakam. Keno Davis's club surrendering a huge run in the closing moments. And Western Kentucky, the pride of the Sun Belt, leads by nine.
Great hustle. Siakam's going to get his points off of running the floor. He beat Jonathan Cox in a foot race.
Amenecker in desperation threw that one over the window. Timeout. Western Kentucky with 3.5 remaining. The commanding lead in this game finally comes with their stars out of the game for the moment. Siakam with a deuce. Western Kentucky's 21 points in the last 7 minutes, Mike, have come without their stars inside and Courtney Lee, their best player. It's got to be good news for young Darren Horn, their head coach.
13-3. Positive bench production for the players off of Western Kentucky's time.
Rogers to inbound it. Brazelton's got it with the clock winding down at the buzzer. Oh, almost knocked it home. Would have been a fitting conclusion to a fantastic last five, and that brings a smile from ear to ear from young Darren Horn. An 18-10 run to close out the half. That's the end of the half. We'll send you to Craig Gumbel with AT&T at the half after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching CBS Sports, home of the men's NCAA basketball championship.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the men's basketball championship is sponsored by Chevy. The Hartford. Gatorade. and by Jordan.
...47-38 Western Kentucky, and the city of Tampa has really been treated to some threes. Here's the in-game box score powered by CBS Sports College Network, the 24-hour college sports channel from CBS Sports. Courtney Lee got out to that quick start. Got a lot of help from his friends and Leonard Houston, Jonathan Cox combining for 21 for Drake. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski as we get ready for second half action.
You know, it's amazing that Western Kentucky has this lead, Timmy, that they've got five guys with two personal fouls each. They did not score at the free throw line.
Unbelievable.
And they, I thought a turning point came late in that second half when Western Kentucky went to the zone. Kept them out of foul trouble a little bit.
Well, we should anticipate a quick start from Drake given the flow of this game and knowing what they've done in the past. Keno Davis is no doubt very confident that his team, particularly with this guy having the ball in his hands, leading the way. Although that time Evans got in the way. He's been an eraser inside, as has Magley. Lee, what a move by Lee, and he draws the foul from Houston.
Second block by Evans in the game, and not a good decision by Emenecker going at him. But here is Courtney Lee. Such a great dribble. He's got a great knack for getting to his right hand, and that's an automatic right there. He's either going to score or get to the free throw line. But consider, Tim, too, that Western Kentucky built this lead with their entire front line on the bench, and Magley
Evans, Magley
and Lee.
Yeah, those three. And as you see, Courtney Lee at the free throw line, the first free throws taken in this game for Western Kentucky. It was Korver that picked up the foul rather than Houston. As usual, the guy coming over to give help is the one that's whistled for the foul.
I think, and you know, you look at Keno Davis, he needed to talk defensively in that halftime speech. 61% for the Hilltoppers in that first half.
Rogers coming out to provide defensive help on Houston. Josh Young, we haven't heard from him in a while. Emenecker with the clock winding down. That was a tough pass to try to thread in there. Leads to a turnover as he was trying to get it into the hands of Jonathan Cox.
And then Western Kentucky needs to be more sound defensively, especially off the dribble. As spread as Drake is, they got him into the penalty early, and that allowed them to get to the free throw line.
Hazleton operating at the point. That's a bump, an offensive foul. Emenecker stood his ground that time, collecting the charge. It's the second foul on Tyrone Brazelton. It could become an issue for Western Kentucky in the second half. It really wasn't in the first because the bench had the back of the starters in a very big way, as we mentioned, a baker's dozen points. Cox on the wing. That was a stressful three-point shot. Lee looking to drive baseline, gives it up to Brazelton. Cox gets the rebound. Well, Drake is usually delivering this kind of action to its opposition. Now they're on the receiving end. Their fan base all in blue just behind their sideline, standing up, trying to encourage their club. 28-4 on the year, 15-3 in regular season and tournament champions in a big way. Emenecker feeds Houston on the wing for three. Cox has it rejected from the back. Lee got a hand on that. Brazelton, length of the floor. Houston got a piece of it. Cox gets the rebound.
Brazelton lucky he didn't get a second offensive foul that time.
This time it's Josh Young. The nylon song for the young man from Lawton, Oklahoma.
And this team taking deep threes, but Young 45% on the year.
Well, that gets him off the schneid. He had missed six. He's now 1 of 7 from downtown, so that may be a big bucket for him. Get his confidence going. 44% on the year from three-point range. Shot clock under 10. Brazelton, nice pass, and Magley has it rejected.
Let's see if Western Kentucky looks to get some post touches while those guys are still in the game.
Hammenecker throwing that one up from the hip after challenging the big fella. And just like that, a foul on Magley, his third. Near the end of today's game, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. To honor their determination and outstanding play, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund, Chevy and American Revolution.
And this is the thing that really helped Drake in the first half. Not only were they building up fouls, Tim, but they were usually shooting fouls like that, so you're getting to the line anyway.
Now just that quickly, Magley forced to sit down with the third. Brazelton also sits out as Boris Siakam comes back into the game. And Orlando Mendez-Valdez joins Courtney Lee and Ty Rogers in the backcourt.
Darren Horn sensing his team fell into a pretty good rhythm in that first half with a smaller lineup. You're giving away some rebounding and points inside in the form of Magley. You have to also look at what's working for you out on the floor.
Jacob Barenbrook, number 11 for Drake, also on the floor now. And Brent Heemskerk. Heemskerk back on the floor for the Bulldogs. Lee on a blow by. Hammenecker got a piece of it. Evans with the follow and then the offensive foul. Credit Jonathan Cox for getting in position to take the charge. And that's three on Jeremy Evans. So those issues that we thought might crop up in the second half for Darren Horn in the first few moments rear their ugly head.
To this point, Tim, it seems that most of the whistles have been charge calls in this game. As a player, you have to realize that, pull up a little short, not try to get all the way to the rim.
Stephon Pettigrew, the freshman from Elizabethtown, Kentucky, has checked into the game, number 30, and there's a turnover. Good defense by Mendez-Valdez.
Hammenecker just in a little bit too much of a hurry to turn the corner, trying to catch the ball going away. Pretty good defense that time. Use the sideline as your ally.
Well, that small lineup that works so well for Horn is back in there. But with the foul problems early for Evans and Magley here in the second half. See how they play in the second half. Mendez-Valdez for three. He rattles it home. The bench points continue to pile up for the Hilltoppers.
Mendez-Valdez, this team 9-1 when he has multiple threes in a game. That was his second.
Rogers got into the passing lane to knock that one away. It was deflected by Korver off of Rogers. So Drake will have it when we come back. Over 4 minutes gone. Oh, play that song. The nylon one.
We'll keep tabs on that game for you. Western Kentucky and Drake about to take the floor again in Tampa. Let's return you to Tim Brando and Mike Jaminski.
Western Kentucky leads it by 8. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski just underway here in the second half. And the foul issues for the Hilltoppers now have put Darren Horn in a position again of having to go small, but so far, that's worked out beautifully for him.
But this lineup, and he's got Pettigrew and Siakam in there, still a couple of post players. There you see the foul issues. It was when they had that fourth scorer on the floor that they really opened things up on the perimeter.
Drake started 6 out of 10 from the floor. They're 5 of 21 since, so they've hit a cold spell. Hammenecker finds a wide open Korver. Boy, he was waiting on that one, wasn't he?
Western Kentucky coming with a trap out of the timeout, and Drake played out of it and saw the guy on the weak side.
And then they get the turnover off the inbounds with some pressure. Make Dr. Tom very proud watching his son pull that off.
Yeah, Hammenecker just very poised with the basketball and knew exactly where Korver was going to be on the weak side.
Amazing every time you watch these teams. A made basket allows you to pressure.
Boy, a turnover, unforced error that time by Jonathan Cox. Right back into the hands of Courtney Lee for Western Kentucky. Both of these teams can score in bunches. And they've proven that in the first half. Lee off the bounce. He is some good.
Good recognition. He's got the shorter Josh Young in that matchup zone right in front of him. He just jumped up over the top of him.
Oh, Houston now turning down some shots. Young. That's an offensive foul. Nice work by Siakam coming over. That's the third time Boris Siakam has collected a charge.
Here's the look right there. Now you got Courtney Lee right here recognizing he's got a shorter player. No way he's going to bother that shot. He just played right over the top of Lee at 6'5", Josh Young at 6'1".
Young picking up his third foul. Forced to sit down now for Drake. And another quick foul. This one against Korver. And Keno Davis is in disbelief. And just like that, two Bulldogs with three fouls. Two prominent ones, Korver and Young. Now that equalizes the foul situation for both teams, particularly when you consider both of them, both of these teams rely heavily on these guys from a scoring standpoint.
You've got Heemskerk coming into the game, and you gain some size up front, but you definitely lose a lot of three-point firepower in the form of Korver.
Heemskerk, number four, back on the floor for the Bulldogs. In traffic, Pettigrew not there. Mendez Valdez tries to save it. Out of bounds to Drake.
Now it's funny, because of that foul trouble, Tim, what that's going to do is there you see those two sitting on the bench with three fouls each. If he so chooses, that Darren Horn might be able to come back big.
Yeah.
It gives him that option.
Dangerous pass that time by Baron Brooks. On the wing, three-pointer does not fall for Cox. And they're off to the races again. Brazelton back to Lee. Missed the chippy, but there's the follow. Siakam.
A lot of help on the way. How many times do you see it that a deep three from the corner on a miss turns into the first pass and a fast break? Western Kentucky very quick moving it from end to end.
Well, you see the points in the paint. That's been a difference maker. Western Kentucky, those putbacks. Athletic, angular, wing players quicker to the ball when it's up on the rim. Another steal. Emenecker with a poor pass. Courtney Lee takes it away. Brazelton. Yes, and a foul. 3+1.
That was a very unselfish play by Courtney Lee. Seeing Brazelton up ahead. Defensive lapse by Drake. Another great time to get a good look at a three in transition. Everybody scattered. Brazelton had a terrific look.
Baron Brook got the foul. And here's Tyrone Brazelton at the line.
12 points, 4 rebounds, 4 assists in the game for him.
What another long-range specialist. Went 9 of 12 from downtown in a game back on December the 29th against Troy. He can light it up.
He is dominating the matchup with Emenecker in this game.
Siakam that time was beaten off the bounce by Houston and will pick up the foul. First on Boris, who's really played well coming in to spell some of that front line for Western Kentucky. The lead has catapulted to 14 now. This 9-0 run. Both teams capable of scoring and doing so quickly. Houston leaves it on the front iron. Well, you can see now some of the stress for this Drake team as Korver can't connect. Trying to get it back all at once. Tough to do. And the foul does go against Siakam again, his second. You sometimes get behind by this much early, Mike, and you begin to press.
Well, and if you're Western Kentucky, though, Tim, the thing that happens, one, three-point shots become a lot harder in the second half of an NCAA tournament game. Two, you can live with them inside taking two-point shots.
Monday on CBS, a Britney update here. Britney Spears guest stars on a new episode of How I Met Your Mother at 8:30, 7:30 Central on CBS.
break this half. Two field goals, six turnovers. And those missed opportunities at the line are difficult to take, particularly when you're as good a shooter as Korver is. 7 minutes gone, and the lead has been upped to 13 for Western Kentucky, the Sun Belt representative, tournament champions. Slaughter rejected.
Jonathan Cox, nice defensive play in the zone.
Korver, St. Petersburg again. St. Petersburg is calling, and it's a 10-point game.
Well, look at the speed of Brazelton get through that trap.
Brazelton tries to answer, and he does.
And this is the thing, Western Kentucky, while getting beaten at the line, has had every answer for Drake from behind the three-point line.
The manner in which they get the threes, diametrically different, but oh, how effective. Emenecker, too strong off the glass. Cox rejected by Evans. Young for three. The tap out to Rogers, and Western Kentucky controls. Rogers pumps. Everything falling for the Hilltoppers. Timeout, Drake. They are bringing some Sun Belt.
They're coming up on 4 minutes of play there in Birmingham. We'll keep track for you. Let's get you back to Tampa, where Western Kentucky leads Drake. Once again, Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski.
Of the 19 total points for Western Kentucky in this half, 15 of them have come on trades. And just like that, Drake finds himself down by 16. Korver, out of the timeout, gets the well-designed three ball.
He's been terrific, and almost unguardable from where he's shooting that ball. He's hoisted a couple of 30-footers up.
16 for Clayton Korver today. Siakam. Well, that time, Horn almost called a timeout and then pulled it back. He thought his man was trapped. Said, no, I'll just wait. Rogers. Shot clock winding down for Slaughter, who must initiate something and does.
Wow.
Yeah, A.J. Slaughter, again, talk about coming under control and taking the offensive charge out. He came to the two-foot stop. Nice balance.
Former is one three ball away from tying the school record. He has the last 10 Drake points, and there's a charge. Drake will have it when we come back as Slaughter turns it over. The Hilltoppers are climbing it and doing it from outside and inside, all around the town. As you look at our game summary, Mike, I think the difference is clearly points in the paint for Western Kentucky, most of those coming off the offensive glass.
No, they've done a nice job there, second chance points, and also a lot of rushes up the floor. Now, one of the things, too, they've kept Drake off the free throw line in this half, Tim. Only four after having 16 in the first half. The reason why, Drake having to get back in this with three-point shooting, not attacking the rim.
Losing those bigs in both the early portion of the first half and second half have really allowed Western Kentucky to go small, which has been a greater matchup for them. Emenecker trying to navigate. Cox there for the answer. So a rare putback for Drake.
By the time that they were drawn off by penetration, that allowed Cox to get down to, right on the offensive glass.
Lee. Not this time. Ball tapped out into the hands of Josh Young, who's playing with three. Gives it up to Korver. Houston, nice look, and the rejection. Evans slapping it away.
Third block of the game. Look for Western Kentucky to really extend their defense. I think they can live with twos. They just don't want those big bombs from the outside in the last 9:45.
Magley back out on the deck along with Evans makes them far more imposing when you attack the glass as the opposition. And they've had a few return defenders already in this game. As you mentioned, four for Evans all told in the game. Rogers runs the curl. And Magley there to clean it up.
We'll call that an assist.
Yeah. Little Wittenberg to Lorenzo Charles maneuver.
On a little smaller stage.
Yes.
I always felt, though, that the offensive rebounder, Tim, had an advantage in that because the defensive guy not willing to go up and get a goaltending call.
The three ball for Jonathan Cox at 6'8". He can really step out. Loves the wing jumper.
Fifteen for him.
And even with Brazelton out of the game, Western Kentucky really handling the pressure well.
Boy, that Drake fans want it over and back. And I understand why. Rogers gets a gift. Aquino Davis is absolutely right. That ball should have been an over and back. That ball was not deflected. Emenecker. That'll be a block going against Evans. Should be number four. And you see Jamie Lucky now trying to explain it to Keno Davis. That absolutely no way that could not be an over and back.
And that's in there. So I think they're saying right there that Emenecker got a fingertip on the ball when it was being passed out. But this turned in, instead of a turnover, turned into 2 points on the other end, a 4 point swing.
Yeah, he's in a game like this, that's a big swing. You see Evans picking up the fourth, but at that stage, they really needed it. CBSSports.com covers every minute of the madness. Get expert analysis, watch highlights and buzzer beaters, plus live scoring and stats for every game, all at CBSSports.com.
Once again, with 8:30 to go, that Drake in the penalty from here on out. They only have four fouls, so Western Kentucky a little ways away from that.
Emenecker's points only at the free throw line. Not one field goal for him today. There's Brazelton.
Boy, a whirling dervish. That quickness and athleticism has been a real difference maker. Brazelton now with 18.
On credit, you talk about no field goal attempts. Good credit, Jeremy Evans inside for Western Kentucky and the way he has guarded the front of the rim.
The issue for Drake. Not only are they struggling on this end when they drive to the basket, but getting stops on the other end. Emenecker unable to get it to fall. Cox stays with it at point blank range, and finally a whistle. 7:42 remaining. Drake will be at the stripe when we come back. Tonight on The Late Show, don't miss Sean Diddy Combs. Monday, Dave's All New with Demi Moore and Counting Crows, only on CBS.
Nice, Sean Diddy Combs, you're wearing some of his work. As you look at our score, 74-59, Western Kentucky. Speaking of great work, how about Tyrone Brazelton?
He has been special today, Tim. You look at it, 6 of 10 from the field, 5 of 8 from 3, and he's done it in a variety of fashions. The nice kick out right there, getting his feet set, this in transition. Emenecker a little slow to get up, and then he also shows some versatility getting into the lane. 18 points for him, 3 rebounds and 4 assists. A very solid line.
Jonathan Cox now at the free throw line. And Brazelton has been unstoppable, as has really the Western Kentucky bench. Mike, they have outscored Drake's bench 22-3.
8 separate players, 3 guys in double figures, 8 separate players scoring for Western Kentucky, and 2 of them, Magley and Evans, right at 8 points. So very, very balanced for the Hilltoppers.
Great games all across the board on day 2 in the opening round of the NCAA tournament. Yesterday, the 12s could not quite navigate the 5s. Today, perhaps a different story. Courtney Lee going to the offhand. Rebound to Jonathan Cox.
Well, with both Brazelton and Mendez Valdez, this is going to be a tough team to press. You have 2 very good point guards.
Young, Cox, he puts it down with the tip. And Drake trying to step up the pace with pressure.
One bucket away from turning it into a single-digit game. This tough team from the Midwest, the heartland, and adopted Cinderella for this NCAA tournament, trying to show some grit.
I think they have to win. They have to take this as a 4-minute game. Get under the 4-minute mark, try to make it under 4, and then it's very doable.
Magley lost it.
And the Bulldogs get it back. Still plenty of time. I thought earlier in the half when Drake fell behind, Mike, they were rushing their shots on the offensive end. And now it seems that Keno Davis has gathered his guys and gotten some composure.
Timeout, Western Kentucky. 9 of Drake's last 10 by Jonathan Cox.
The lead is 11, and you see the last time the 12s beat 5s in 2006. That really indicates margin is, I think, slimmer than ever between the 12s and 5s.
Well, I mentioned that same thing to you at breakfast today. We're talking about it, but that's, you could throw a blanket over those teams. And, you know, if Western Kentucky were going and seal this deal, I don't even you can call it an upset.
Agreed. It's all about matchups. Corver on the wing. Courtney Lee brings down the rebound.
Talk about it. Western Kentucky's going to have to be solid. All five guys have to hang in there for the rebounds. There's going to be a lot of threes taken by Drake down the stretch.
Loose ball taken away by Drake's Josh Young. Houston fouled by Magley.
And this is what Drake needs to do. We talked about their advantage at the free throw line all day today. 19 of 24 to this point, Tim. Western Kentucky 2 of 3 in the game. But what this does, it slows the pace of the game down. So the extent that they can knock threes and get to the line will serve them well in a comeback attempt.
Well, a break for Magley. Brazelton got that foul rather than Magley. Well, Darren Horn, the youthful coach of this Western Kentucky team, a part of the last Sun Belt winner in this NCAA tournament. Was on the team that defeated Michigan in the first round, had 13 in that game. Yeah. What an opportunity this would be for him to bring back some history and tradition to the Sun Belt Conference. They love their basketball in Bowling Green. And near steal and a reach-in foul will be the call. It goes against Corver, and that's number 4. Keno Davis did not need him to get a fourth foul.
And I don't know right now. It may be. That's a tough call right there, but it may be. Keno Davis is in a tough situation right now because he's in a comeback mode right now, and you can't afford to lose that three-point shooter.
That's a scramble situation. I mean, you talk about advantage, disadvantage, Mike. No one had an advantage or disadvantage in that situation. That's a bad break for Drake.
Well, what Corver has to do now is understand where he is and play accordingly.
In traffic, that steps.
Three turnovers in the last three possessions for Western Kentucky. They need to regain their poise. Let's look for their guy Courtney Lee to step forward here and finish this game off.
5:53 remaining. Magley has played well given the foul difficulty he had in the first half. So has Evans. Emenecker on the wing for Young. Just off the mark and a tie ball. Oh no, I thought he had a tie. They picked up the foul instead.
No, Jonathan Cox that time. Good call. He really wrapped up Evans' arms.
So that's his first foul. Western Kentucky gets it back. Well, some opportunities now missed for this great team after Western Kentucky's been somewhat careless with the ball. Brazelton lost it. Yeah, that's 4 in a row now.
And I think at time, if you're Western Kentucky and Darren Horn, let's see the play right here on the inbounds. Brazelton, it did, went right off his chest. Instead of Magley in the game, they need an extra ball handler out on the floor to handle the press.
Suddenly that collar getting a little tighter on the 31-year-old head coach. Had control of this game, and now the Bulldogs, if they can muster a few threes, which has been their calling card all year, they could be right back in it. Houston. Corver the follow. 74-66. And the foul committed by Young. Take a look at our tournament summary. Duke escaped last night with a 1-point win over Rick Byrd's Belmont team, and Mississippi Valley State held to the fewest
in tournament action since 1946 by that suffocating UCLA defense.
Took a heroic play at the end by Gerald Henderson. They were right at the brink of defeat, but 11 seconds to go, he goes coast to coast and gets the lay-in.
Had my partner just a little bit on edge.
Never a doubt.
Oh yeah, right.
And not even Vince Gill in the hall could bring Belmont through, but they played an outstanding game.
He's headed here, by the way, for the Vanderbilt game, as you know. He loves his basketball, so Vince Gill will be in our building later on this afternoon and this evening.
Very good friend with Kevin Stallings.
'76-66. With 15 to play, they were down by 10, and then suddenly another Western Kentucky run. Emenecker continues to draw fouls, and that's Jeremy Evans' fifth.
So that's a shot blocker erased for Western Kentucky, and he played big in this game. But when they've had to go small, Mike, they've also had answers there as well. And as you indicated, maybe an extra ball handler wouldn't hurt.
As you look at it, I don't know that that's a huge loss, especially for the way they played and where they're going to have to play the rest of this game.
8 points, seven boards, a couple of blocks for him, and they came at big moments in the game.
You just get a feeling you're trying to get over the hump. Siakam's going to come in, who's more of an athletic body underneath, a guy that'll take some charges for you, but you get a feeling that getting over this hump is tough for Western Kentucky.
The thing that they're faced with, though, Tim, you look at it, one, they need ball handlers out there, but two, even on the threes, Drake has been very good offensive rebounding the ball, so he's stuck between having two bigs out there to try to cover the glass or get a guy in there when they convert and get into press mode.
All of Adam Emenecker's points have come at the line today. His nickname is Ace. Adam, obviously, his mother's maiden name, Kanata, and last name, Emenecker, Vince Ace. And he gets them both to fall here, and it's 76-68. There's the pressure again.
Got to stay out of the corners of that press.
That was not easy to cut across the timeline for Western Kentucky.
See how long it takes for Brazelton to initiate. Lee, that's a pretty good choice.
Halfway down the cylinder and out. Collected by Jonathan Cox. This building will explode if Drake can score here, and there's a foul.
Travel.
Well, we're going to get an overrule. Jamie Lucky may have seen a foul before the steps. That's what I saw. Kino saying, wait a minute. There was a bump. Stevens talked Lucky out of it. Let's go now over to Greg Gumbel in New York. With Jonathan Cox at the free throw line after Magley committed a foul on the free throw line a moment ago. That's his fourth. He goes and sits down now. Drake is inching closer to making this a fun finish with 4:42 remaining. They were down by 16 at one point in this half. Suddenly a two-possession game. The Hilltoppers have turned it over far too often, and Siakam is fouled.
As Brazelton is so quick with the basketball.
Brent Heemskerk picked up that foul.
And at least now Western Kentucky, it's a fair fight at the free throw line. They never got into the penalty in the first half.
Amazing that they had the lead given those numbers. As you see Korver re-entering the game, Heemskerk sits down. The offense for defensive substitution, Korver playing with four fouls. Horace Siakam has played so well off that Hilltoppers bench.
They've gotten a lot of contributions.
Jonathan Cox, that's where he likes it. Every time he gets it on the wing, he's a threat. Brazelton, numbers, a solo, a kiss, counted, and a foul on Jonathan Cox. How big was that?
Well, wow. Cox was the one who took the jumper out of the corner, but the speed, and how about going to left hand? Yeah, that's a good call. Cox trying to buy the foul. Wasn't even close.
See, that healthy contingent from Des Moines, Iowa would disagree. They are making the most noise here. Both of these teams have rich traditions and history. Drake playing for the national title in 1969. Western Kentucky, EA Diddle Arena, one of the outstanding sights in college basketball. If you've ever been to Bowling Green for a game, you know what I'm talking about. 22 now for Brazelton. 80 to 73 with 4 minutes remaining. Oh, a turnover that time by Houston. Unforced error. Lee tries to follow. Two missed from point blank range. Darren Horn really upset.
Well, what he's talking about, they grabbed the rim and it snapped back, but it didn't look like it affected the shot.
Let's go back to Greg Gumbel. 80 to 73 our score. The ball will belong to Western Kentucky, but they got really a poor break just a moment ago. Drake clearly was on the rim and it went uncalled. It affected a putback opportunity, but we'll see if the Hilltoppers can take advantage. They do have 34 to shoot. Brazelton leading the way for this Western Kentucky team, along with Sunbelt Player of the Year Courtney Lee. He's out there now with Slaughter, Boris Siakam, and that young man, Ty Rogers. He gives it up to Courtney Lee running the curl. That's a beautiful play out of the timeout.
Wow, he is so good when he comes to his right hand. Again, I love the jump stop short of where trouble is. Well under control.
Amenecker bumped by Slaughter and will pick up the foul.
Here's that last possession we were talking about a moment ago. This clearly should have been goaltending.
Yeah, because the rim snapped up while the ball was on the rim. But you know, at the end result of it, that Western Kentucky was able to retain possession and get a score out of the timeout.
Amenecker at the free throw line. This kid is all about what's right within a collegiate athletics, Mike. Yesterday, a loose ball situation came over to you, and he looked at you and said, "Excuse me, sir, may I have the basketball?"
Very polite, but yep. Made me feel extremely old.
Yes, he did. 82 to 75. Siakam wrapped up by Heemskerk. Well, not a bad foul. They're looking to extend this game at this particular point. Siakam's a 68% free throw shooter.
An advantage, Drake, there as a team, 76%. Outstanding. Hilltoppers just under 70.
Thought it was interesting talking with Keno yesterday about his dad, and he asked him to come to the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament. He didn't. He's been adamant about not wanting to jinx him, but of course he talks to him every day. His dad never lost a first-round NCAA tournament game. Dr. Tom Davis, maybe three schools there, 11-0, a perfect 11-0 in first-round play.
You didn't want to face him with 5 days of preparation time.
No, you didn't. 83-75. That bench points stat means everything. Korver rattles it home, playing with four fouls, and it's a five-point game. Slaughter. That ball knocked away, tipped by Drake. Look at the distance on this, Mike.
11 of 12 shots from behind the arc, and that's a good 30 feet again.
You talk about a designated assassin playing with four fouls. He's it.
Western Kentucky forced to take the timeout, or we would have had a five-second violation. Drake has stormed back in this game, trailing by 16 at one point, and Kyle Korver, with his long-range shooting, has helped propel the Bulldogs of the Missouri Valley right back into this game.
33 of 55 field goals attempted from beyond the arc, and some of those from well beyond the arc, like Clayton Korver. In that time, he and Cox combined for 45 points.
Korver, Kyle Korver, tying a great school record for three balls, has put his team back into this game. They trail by five, 3:07 remaining against Western Kentucky.
Turnovers have been the issue for Western Kentucky. And whistle stops play off the inbounds pass. Might we get a mulligan here?
Yep.
Yeah, I believe we will. A do-over.
Hilltoppers retain possession.
Yes, they do. It draws the ire of the Drake fans. And again, that pressure. Oh, and a foul committed. It'll go against.
I think it's Emenecker.
Emenecker, his second.
But I was wondering with this move coming in, because I thought Mendez Valdez really helped them against the press early on. You see the subtle little push there.
Right into the scores table, Mendez Valdez.
The thing it does with him on the floor, they're smaller, but they give you a 40% three-point shooter and an 80% free throw shooter.
Yeah, that's why you saw the reaction from Emenecker, knowing that that's not the man you want to put at the line, and yet he misses the first. Kyle Korver comes in. Heemskerk sits down. Offense for defense for Keno Davis. In the NCAA tournament for the first time since 1971. We're in Tampa, Florida. Drake, trailed by as many as 16, have fought back here in the second half to close it to six. And we've got a tie ball with the arrow to the Bulldogs. Western Kentucky's bench has been a difference, outscoring Drake by 20, 23-3 in this game. Darren Horn, who played for the last Sun Belt team to ever win an NCAA tournament game, only 31 years of age. That victory for Western Kentucky, Ralph Willard was coaching back then, came against Michigan.
Talked yesterday how much of a mentor and how much he learned from Ralph Willard. A lot of his coaching style, coaching tactics coming from him.
Leonard Houston knows how to score off the dribble himself, gives it up. That's Young, Josh Young, not there. And the rebound cleared to Western Kentucky. Courtney Lee driving the baseline, cut off by Emenecker. Two possession game, but the clock winding down, and Darren Horn waiting to let that clock wind down, and Keno Davis a little upset with that foul by Leonard Houston. Didn't want it.
Oh, but even said, you talk about who the guys are to foul. Brazelton, as well as he's played and as big a part as he is of this team, 68% from the line.
Our game reset for you. Western Kentucky in control of the game. They also have the arrow. Both teams are in the double bonus. Plenty of timeouts for both teams still to utilize. And the three ball has been such a vital cog for both of these teams. You can bet that there are a few more left in each team's arsenal.
For most of the game, too, Tim Magley and Evans, the two bigs for Western Kentucky, have been on the bench. They've chosen to go smaller and match Drake's firepower.
Emenecker creates, and there's a slam. Whoa, Leonard Houston. And now a turnover, the travel off the pressure of a made basket. How many times have we seen that today?
Now, Leonard Houston, this again, this is Emenecker. This is what he does and what he means. He collapses the defense, and the big finish by Leonard Houston.
Textbook Emenecker dish, too. Just creating on the dribble drive with the floor spread. Get everyone away from the basket and let him negotiate. Houston again. Barely drew iron. Rogers comes away with a rebound. Missed opportunity that time for Drake. Brazelton all the way to the rack. Houston has Young down there with him. Gives it up. Young would have counted had it fallen.
Amazing how Drake has taken control of this game. There was plenty of times early on they could have gone away with a 16-point lead or being down by 16, but they have just been very patient in clawing their way back in, knocking down big threes and getting to the free throw line.
Courtney Lee got the foul, his third. And a reminder, coming up next on the road to the Final Four, South Alabama against Butler with a great another Sun Belt team in action. UMBC against Georgetown, Austin Peay, Dave Luce's team taking on Texas. 86-82. Lee runs down that dangerous pass by Slaughter. Amenecker and Young converging. Brazelton throws it away.
Great pursuit by Cox after the play to make the steal.
From way downtown, Young. Only the Young survive. It's a one-point game. Timeout. Hilltoppers. How about that? The Heartland loves them. Will the Cinderella slipper continue to fit for Drake?
Amenecker once again making that play hot possible. Josh Young, what a game he has had. And Tim, what, you know, what poise that Drake has shown, being down big time double figures, but knowing that there's plenty of time left on the clock.
Amenecker, as tough as it's been on him today, still 12 assists, Mike. And this is now a 26-12 run. They trailed by as many as 16 here in the second half.
Well, he's not defined by his scoring. Consider he is the fifth leading scorer on his team. We're not talking the conference, on his team. He is 0 for 7 from the field, but still a double-double. 11 points, 12 assists for him.
And again, we've seen in the last few minutes, too, Mike, what can happen. As capable as Western Kentucky is, their length, their athletic ability, but they don't have in Brazelton the pure point guard that maybe Amenecker is. And so turnovers now have become a real factor in the second half against Western Kentucky.
Well, I think Mendez Valdez is probably the most pure playmaker that they have out on the floor.
They have 13 turnovers in this half, 20 total in the game.
If you're Darren Horn now, you're talking confidence to your team, because through all of this, you still have the lead.
Yeah.
And you've got 31 seconds to get a good possession. So this is a very, very big possession for them from a mental health standpoint.
Let's go, Drake. What you're hearing in the building here in Tampa, much of their contingent being heard from.
Gotta love the Drake.
Yeah. Last appearance in the NCAA tournament, 1971. Rogers just got it in and gets it back from Brazelton. Now Tyrone will set up shot.
And almost put Brazelton in a bad way by delivering it along the sideline.
It's been a while since Courtney Lee's had a quality touch. Out of a 1-4 set, they're going to milk some clock here and let Brazelton initiate against Amenecker. Brazelton, a leaner, got it to go. Just an isolation play for him. He has 26.
And played through a couple of grabs by Amenecker, too. A lot of strength.
Korver almost launched it from 35 feet. Amenecker gives it up to Cox on the wing. He loves that. He loves that. That's his spot on the floor. We're tied at 88. Timeout. Are you feeling it, big fella? Are you feeling it? This big fella is. Jonathan Cox has 17 points in the last 10 minutes. We'll be back. At long last, this hill has been climbed against the Hilltoppers by Drake. We're tied at 88, but alas, Mike, it's Western Kentucky that should get the last shot.
Right, and that's the key point right there. You want that to happen. Last time they let Brazelton go on a clear out with Amenecker. Certainly a quickness. And you want to hit the lane with about 5 or 4 seconds to go to give yourself, one, a shot opportunity, and two, an offensive rebounding opportunity.
No timeouts remaining for Western Kentucky. And given the pressure that Drake's brought, that's significant.
They've had issues getting the ball inbounds.
Just got it in. That's Slaughter down on the baseline. That's a foul. Amenecker draws the charge from A.J. Slaughter. That's 5 on Slaughter. Talk about basketball acumen to go along with the academic quality.
Stepping in that time. Great lead. And the Slaughter just trying to do too much out of the corner that time.
So now it's Drake with a chance to win it in the final possession. And Korver re-entering the game offensively. So many options available to Keno Davis. Korver, Houston, Jonathan Cox has scored 17 in the last 10 minutes of this game.
Well, I thought actually that Drake a little late to come in and huddle up, because Western Kentucky taking some time to get their player in after fouling out.
Brazelton, Rogers, Mendez, Valdez, Courtney Lee, and Siakam, the five on the floor for Western Kentucky.
Is there a better guy you want making the play at the end of the game than Emenecker?
I don't think so. He will dictate the pace. His nickname is Ace. We'll see what he comes up with here. Missouri Valley Conference Player of the Year. Most impactful walk on this tournament scene in a long time. There he is. High off the window, pulled down by Brazelton. We'll play another session in Tampa. A 29-14 run to close out this game for Drake. And the Valley and the Sun Belt will go at it for five more minutes. Tim Brando, Mike Kaminsky here at the West Region. Tampa, Florida, the site. Western Kentucky led by as many as 16 in the second half break. An incredible comeback. And we're tied at 88. Mike Kaminsky, I think probably the advantage has to be to Drake. Even though Korver's playing with four, Evans is out. Magley's playing with four. And Western Kentucky's been struggling now to control the basketball. And a quick reminder of what we've got coming up next in this NCAA tournament. We'll be going out to see these games: South Alabama, Butler, Georgetown, UMBC, Austin Peay, Texas.
It's been funny, and a couple of things have been going on for Western Kentucky that Courtney Lee has been very quiet over this stretch. A couple of baskets late, but only 6 of 15 shooting, 15 points for him. They've kept him under control. And when Drake wasn't making threes, they were getting to the free throw line.
And the story was Jonathan Cox for Drake from downtown. Korver hit a couple of big ones, but it was Cox down the stretch that made the big ones. And Emenecker tries to feed him, cutting to the basket, and it's knocked out of bounds. 23 to shoot. But this is such a difficult team to defend because so many of them have that howitzer from downtown that they can ring out almost at any point.
A lot like Belmont.
Yep,
in the game
indeed.
Last night.
A leaner off the glass by Leonard Houston. Yeah, they're very remindful of that Belmont team that Rick Bird has.
Now all of a sudden, five players in double figures for Drake.
Brazelton, boy, has he been tough. 28 in the game for the point guard for Western Kentucky. Emenecker feeds Josh Young. He had one of those big ones in the comeback as well. 93-90.
Well, I love the unselfishness, and they really don't care who gets the look at the three, and Emenecker does such a great job at finding out his 14th assist of the game.
Young, another first-team All-Missouri Valley Conference performer. 14th assist by Emenecker. That is a career high. Brazelton again. Rebound to Young. And you wonder how Western Kentucky will handle being more than maybe one possession behind. They've led this game since the halfway mark in the first 20 minutes. Korver. Rebound to Courtney Lee.
Well, the last thing you want to have to do is win a game twice.
Yep.
And that's exactly what Western Kentucky is going to have to do right now. And I think it's going to be this guy with the ball, Courtney Lee, that's going to have to step up.
Brazelton. Oh, he gets the shooter's touch.
Yep, he's been incredible.
93-92. You're right, though. Courtney Lee, Mike, has been invisible in the last 10 minutes of regulation and now in the overtime. Korver pumps off the front rim. Courtney Lee runs it down. Got Brazelton on the other end. A little hesitation that time from Brazelton. Didn't give it back to Courtney Lee, and it didn't appear that Lee wanted it.
Well, no, and Korver wasn't going to come out and challenge him. He almost dared him to shoot the jump shot.
Back and forth we go in Tampa. Jonathan Cox prefers the wing, not up top.
It's really fun to watch players that know where their place on the floor is. You know, Jonathan Cox turned down a shot because he knows that's not where he really wants to get it.
Well, not only that, but it's fun to play with a guy who will get you the ball on those spots in the floor when you're open.
Yeah.
And that's Adam Emenecker.
as Siakam that time was trying to knock it away. I believe the ball may have been kicked. And Josh Young will trigger it in again with 18 on the shot clock. And a timeout by Keno Davis. He saw that they were in a bit of trouble with 2:25 remaining.
Drake leads it by one.
It has been a fun start in Tampa. There you see our game reset, and the possession arrow is to Western Kentucky. Drake leading by one. And a reminder, those of you slated to see these games will be getting you out there for those first round matchups. Out to Birmingham we go for South Alabama, essentially a home game for them. The Mobile, Alabama, not far from Birmingham, about 3.5 hours south. UMBC, Georgetown, and in Little Rock, Austin Peay taking on Texas. San Diego and Connecticut yet to come here in Tampa. Brazelton, look at that, 30, a career high for him.
And the subtle little geography lesson from my partner there.
I've been to the upper corner of Lower Alabama before. Yes, I have. They, of course, out of the Sun Belt, as is Western Kentucky. Young! Oh, it's so good to be young and outstanding. 96-92.
Right, it's like Emenecker, he's at the buffet of the three-point shooters. Who do I want to tee up next?
6 points in the overtime belonging to Josh Young for Drake. Courtney Lee. Rogers, and he's fouled on the putback by Jonathan Cox.
Now, this Western Kentucky team, most of this game, Mike, I think you would agree, were quicker to loose ball opportunities. That's how they got this lead for young Darren Horn.
Yep, getting to the offensive glass, getting some turnovers. And it just looked like the way they were playing early in the second half, they were going to run away with this game.
See, only 14 free throws on the season for this young man. He needs them now.
Keep in mind, too, that I think one of the big keys for Drake, Clayton Korver, able to hang in. He's had four personal fouls for a long time.
Really intelligent the way Keno Davis handled that foul difficulty and the offensive for defensive substitutions he was able to make.
Rogers gets one of the two.
Cox just got number four, so he joins Korver with four for Drake.
And they need his offense, as we documented. 17 of the last 27 points, number 31 for Drake, picked up to help send this game into OT. Josh Young really feeling it now. Has to give it up to Korver. Well defended by Lee. One more time, not this time. And Boris Siakam the rebound.
Chance to tie or pull to within one for Western Kentucky. Lee or Brazelton? Why not Tyrone?
Yes, sir. 33 for him. We're tied at 96.
Great to see the urgency of an overtime game in the first round of an NCAA tournament. Brazelton has been a hero tonight.
12 of Western Kentucky's last 13 belong to Brazelton. Korver. Lee gets the rebound.
Emenecker the steal. Adam Emenecker with a huge pick.
Not giving up on the play.
9 second, 10 second differential between the shot clock and game clock.
Emenecker still didn't have a field goal, but has done everything else in this game.
And Horn cannot believe Siakam came out and fouled Leonard Houston. That's not what he wanted. He wanted to play straight up. It's almost a 12-second differential between the shot and the game clock. They could afford to play straight up that time.
And you put an 80% free throw shooter there as well.
Houston 5 of 8 today. You could hear a pin drop. Great faithful waiting for this one to fall. We'll get you guys out to the start of your game, South Alabama Butler. Wherever you're slated, you'll get there as soon as this one is over. Only one of the two, and again, ball tapped out. Brazelton's got it against Emenecker. Not there. Courtney Lee can't follow it. Siakam
On the way up, a foul spotted.
Now, Emenecker did a great job of keeping Brazelton in front of him, but great pursuit on that play by Western Kentucky after the miss.
And it's on Korver, and that's five. He thought he had gotten a tie ball, but it was a reach in on Clayton Korver. And that'll do it for him. Boy, but he has done the family Korver proud today, hasn't he? His mother Lane is here, his dad, his pastor, one of the outstanding clergymen in the Midwest in Pella, Iowa, Kevin. And of course, Kyle, his brother, and another brother, Caleb, all looking in. 21-15 in this half for Clayton Korver.
Everybody trying to come over and boost the spirits of Boris Siakam, 68% shooter. 3 of 5 in this game. None more important that he's had in his career, I'd imagine.
Out of Cameroon. He can redeem himself after that foul a bit earlier, too. Tremendous moment for him. Elbows clenched here in Tampa. We thought coming in it might be the team with the last possession. Drake had an opportunity in regulation. Now they'll get a chance in overtime. Trailing by one. The Hilltoppers looking for the first NCAA tournament win since 95. You look at our game reset. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski here in Tampa, 98-97. Any tie ball would go to Drake. Jonathan Cox had 17 of the last 27 points, and yet in overtime has not scored. And with Korver out, he and Josh Young probably in Houston are your most viable options here, don't you think?
Well, I know that the key thing is you don't need a three to win the game. Yeah, so, yeah. You know, Emenecker is going to be able to, he's going to have plenty of options. If he can get into the paint, he can draw and pitch to a jump shooter or get something inside.
Heemskerk is on the floor. The rest of the five for Drake, including Cox in Houston, Young, Emenecker, and him. And Brazelton, Siakam and company. High pick coming from Jonathan Cox as Emenecker negotiates. Drives it right to the rack. A relentless move. Stays with it. Emenecker again. Cox a tip. Not there. Loose ball. And a foul. 5.7 remaining.
Timmy, you talked about it early on that Western Kentucky had been fastest to loose balls, but on this possession, it was Drake that kept the ball alive until Jonathan Cox could come up with it at the end. Emenecker staying on it. A couple of shots up there, a couple of tips.
Mendez Valdez finally whistled for the foul. So here is Jonathan Cox.
27-16.
76% on the year at the line. And Darren Horn will ice him. 5.7 remaining. Take a breath. We'll be right back. Young man that earned his scholarship after his freshman year, original walk-on Jonathan Cox at the line. Second team All-MVC, fourth in the league in three-point shooting efficiency. Had 11 double-doubles this year at the free throw line for this crucial one to get Drake the lead. And Mike, for Western Kentucky, plenty of time to get back down the floor.
I think you've got to get two people in front of Brazelton. Do not allow him to get the basketball. Western Kentucky, no timeouts. Make somebody else rush up and beat you.
Oh, the iron kind, and that gives Keno Davis a one-point lead, and he'll take the timeout. Tantalizingly rolling around the rim. Drake, this could be your year. We'll be right back. There's the story. Drake leads it by one. Western Kentucky surrendered a 16-point lead in the second half, but they've been resilient, Mike. And with Brazelton having a career game, you got to believe
either he or Lee are going to be the men.
You got to face guard him, not let him receive the basketball.
Brazelton's got it. End to end, he'll come.
Leaves it for Rogers for three for the win. Western Kentucky doesn't break.
Let's take a look. The rush up the floor. Brazelton, the speed to get things in position. Drew the defenders. Everybody thought he was going to take the shot. Ty Rogers from behind. 38% on the year.
He almost forgot about him, and he's always been a threat from downtown. He just had not been as much of a factor today. Well-designed play by Darren Horn.
Well, in the Sun Belt tournament, 54% from behind the three-point line. It was just a little handoff. Well-run play by Brazelton to draw the defense to him and give his guy an open look.
How about that? Brazelton gets 33, but the winning dime dropped right into the hands of number five, Ty Rogers, senior from Eddyville, Kentucky, Lyon County High School. What an incredible story. And what a first game in Tampa. Our Chevrolet players of the game. Brazelton, a career high with 33. Cox, one of two walk-ons with a double-double. Emenecker being the other for Drake in an heroic performance on the part of that young man. And the winner of our next matchup between Connecticut and San Diego will take on the upstart Hilltoppers of the Sun Belt Conference, winners of an NCAA tournament for the first time since 95, when representing this league, Darren Horn's club managed to knock off Michigan. 101-99, our final in overtime. For Mike Jaminski, Tim Brando saying so long from Tampa. Now let's send you to Greg Gumbel in New York. We're underway, aren't we, Greg?
I believe you're right, Mr. Brando. The action